So we know the Earth is getting warmer. We understand climate change at a big picture, but we're struggling to predict the details of what that means for the Earth. NeuralGCM is a new kind of atmospheric model. We feel it has the potential to transform how we understand climate.
Climate models are a tool helping climate scientists to understand the climate system, both in terms of current climate and future changes in climate, including how much temperature will increase, changes in precipitation patterns, and even current links and how extreme weather events occur.
So conventional climate models work by dividing the Earth into a bunch of small grid cells, typically about 100 kilometers on a side. And those big pixels, you don't see a lot of the details of what happens on the Earth. Like, you can't really see individual clouds.
So although clouds and convection and turbulence are not resolved in climate models, we still represent them. We use approximations, which we call parameterizations, to represent these small-scale processes.
And that really limits the accuracy of climate models. NeuralGCM is a new kind of model for the Earth's atmosphere. It combines the best of physics-based simulations with AI, and it allows us to make much more accurate predictions quickly. AI is really good at picking up on subtle patterns in data and analyzing really large data sets. In climate, small errors can build up over time and become pretty big. With AI, it helps correct for the errors in these models. Scientists are better able to build a more accurate prediction engine, even using relatively coarse grids.
NeuralGCM can simulate in 24 hours, 70,000 days, and it uses a single TPU. Whereas a high-resolution physics-based model in 24 hours can simulate only 19 days using a supercomputer with 13,000 CPUs. So if you want to run a very accurate atmospheric model, instead of using a supercomputer, you could probably use your laptop to do that. Given that we know that climate change is occurring, our certainty in our predictions is highly important for developing adaptation and mitigation policies that would be actually effective and help society.
First, we can mitigate. We can try to better understand how changes in human behavior, like reducing carbon dioxide emissions, would affect future climate. So second, we can adapt to understand what the impact of climate change will be at a regional level. So for example, if we can grow the same crops in the same places, or if we need to build a new seawall in New York Harbor, what sort of extreme weather events are we going to see, like floods or wildfires or heat waves, and how are those going to be different in the future? NeuralGCM is just one piece of the puzzle for understanding climate. We haven't solved it yet. Google decided to make this research open source because we wanted to be able to share this with the broader scientific community and really with the entire world that needs to figure out how to deal with climate change.